وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول
الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد إن شاء الله تعالى I want to talk about certain issues related to the rulings of the fasting of Ashura إن شاء الله تعالى بإذن الله الكريم and my aim إن شاء الله تعالى is to mention 14 important issues of the rulings of Ashura, inshaAllah ta'ala. And these points that I'm going to talk about are going to be mukhtasar, biduni itala. It's going to be very summarized, inshaAllah ta'ala. I'm not going to go in great details, okay? And I hope from Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, rajiyan min Allahi naf'a. I ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala that He makes it a source of benefit, wal ifada, huwa khayru mas'ul wa ma'mul. Allah is the best to ask, subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to hope from. وَمِنْهُ التَّوْفِيقَ And from Allah تبارك وتعالى strength والسداد والقبول comes from. The first مسألة إن شاء الله تعالى that I want to share with all of you بإذن الله الكريم is يوم عاشوراء It's the fasting on the 10th of the month of شهر الله المحرم which is the month that we're in right now. إن شاء الله تعالى عاشوراء is going to be tomorrow بإذن الله الكريم. So it's the fast on the 10th من شهر الله المحرم and this is the madhhab the view of the jumhur al-fuqaha from them is the a'imatu al-arba'a and this view is based purely on the hadith of ibn Abbas radiyallahu ta'ala anhuma where the prophet alayhi salatu wassalam he fasted salawatullahi wa salamuhu alayhi and he commanded wa amara bi siyamihi He commanded the companions to fast and he instructed them to fast. And they said, Ya Rasulullah, the Sahabas, when they saw the Prophet fasting and they saw that the Prophet is commanding them to fast, they said, Ya Rasulullah, إِنَّهُ يَوْمٌ تُعَظِّمُهُ الْيَهُودُ وَالنَّصَارَى It is a day where the Christians and the Jews glorify and they honor and they venerate. فَقَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ The messenger, he said, فَإِذَا كَانَ الْعَامُ الْمُقْبِرُ إِنْ شَاءَ اللَّهُ صُمْنَ الْيَوْمَ التَّاسِعِ The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, if next year comes, we will fast inshaAllah ta'ala on the 9th. And as the narration clearly and categorically mentions, فَلَمْ يَأْتِ الْعَامُ الْمُقْبِرُ حَتَّى تُوُفِيَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ sallallahu alayhi wa sallam رواه مسلم That year never came, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he passed away And he only fasted that year, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So the virtue of fasting and that it's recommended is يعني, agreed upon by the scholars. That it's a virtuous fasting. And Imam Muslim narrated in his Sahih that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, وَصِيَامُ يَوْمُ عَاشُرَىٰ أَحْتَسِبُ عَلَى اللَّهِ أَن يُكَفِّرَ السَّنَةَ الَّتِي قَبْلَهُ The Prophet said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَصِيَامُ يَوْمُ عَاشُرَىٰ Fasting, يعني وصيام يوم عاشوراء Fasting on the 10th of Muharram أحتسب على الله أن يكفر I hope that Allah تبارك وتعالى will forgive and expiate me for the sins and the mistakes and the shortcomings of last year. Okay? So that's the first point, inshallah تعالى, that I wanted to shed light on. That's مسألة الأولى. المسألة الثانية, the second مسألة, the second point that I wanted to discuss inshaAllah ta'ala from the 14 points I'm going to talk about today is that it is virtuous, it's highly recommended to make your intention of Ashura or any fasting which is restricted. Fastings are types. There are fastings which are unrestricted like fasting Mondays and Thursdays and there are fastings which are restricted meaning they have certain timings which they are fast, like fasting of Arafah, which is restricted, and also fasting on Yawmu Ashura, they are called siyamul muqayyada, al-mu'ayyana. It's a restricted, intended fasting. Okay, it's not an unrestricted fasting. It's recommended for the person to come with the intention the night before. But if it's just a unrestricted fasting, you can have your intention the daytime. You can come to your wife and say, is there any food? If she says, no, there is no food, you can say, I'm fasting today. That's fine. Because this fasting is what? It is not muqayyada mu'ayyana. It's not restricted and it's not intended. It's an unrestricted fasting. But like in the fastings of Ashura and Arafah and etc., it's highly recommended that the person comes with the intention the night and the day before. The question here is, if the person comes with the intention after Fajr, so the daytime, they find out that today is Yawm Ashura, or they find out today is Yawm Arafah, and they never came with the intention the night before, will it be accepted from them? Will it be taken into consideration? There is a dispute amongst the scholars. Inshallah ta'ala, bidnillah al-kareem, their fasting will inshallah ta'ala be accepted, but try your best to come with your intention the night before. So it's not going to be the same. The one who comes with the intention the night before and the one who comes with the intention يعني after Fajr. Okay? They're not going to be same. It's like the scholars, they say, like the one who catches up the Salatul Jama'ah from the beginning and the one who catches up the Salatul Jama'ah in the middle, فَلَا يَسْتَوِيَانِ. They're not going to be equal and they're not going to be the same. Even that though they say, وَإِنْ كَانَ كُلٌّ مِّنْهُمَا مُدْرِكٌ لِلصَّلَاةِ. Even though both of them have caught up with the Jama'ah, but one is different from the other. And this is the view that Imam al-Nawawi and Imam Ibn Rajab al-Hanbali and Shaykh al-Allamah Muhammad ibn Salih al-Uthaymeen rahimahullah, he held. So these great giants, the great Imam al-Nawawi rahimahullah and al-Allamah, al-Imam Shaykh al-Islam ibn Rajab al-Hanbali and Shaykh Muhammad ibn Salih al-Uthaymeen, all that, they held that opinion. The third mas'ala, inshaAllah ta'ala, I want to talk about, bi'idhnillahi al-kareem, is the levels of fasting Yawm Ashura. Okay, the levels of the people who fast, the categories and the levels. The first level, inshaAllah ta'ala, is siyamu al-tasi' wal-ashir. Fasting on the 9th and fasting on the 10th. And this is a mahallu ittifaqa. Scholars all unanimously agree on this issue. And this is, of course, based on the hadith of Ibn Abbas. Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhum, I mentioned the hadith where the Prophet ﷺ, he fasted on the 10th and he said, if I live next year, I will fast on the 9th. So by unanimous agreement of the scholars, the 9th and the 10th is a fasting. Okay, and it's legislated and it's sanctioned. Okay, the other level, which is the second level, inshallah ta'ala, is fasting on the 10th and the 11th. So siyam al-ashir, fasting on the 10th and the 11th, which is al-hadid ashar. This is the view of Ba'd al-Malikiyya. Some of the Malikiyya held this opinion, and it is also madhhab al-Shafi'iyya. Okay. The third, inshallah ta'ala, is fasting on Yawm Ashura by itself, and it's not disliked. The third level is fasting on just the 10th, okay, by itself, and that it's not disliked. And this is the view of some of the Hanafiyya. We don't say it's the madhhab al-Hanafiyya, it's not the madhhab. But it's يعني بعض الحنفية hold that opinion. It is the madhhab al-Malikiyya, okay, and the Shafi'iyya and the Hanabila, that it's disliked fasting on the 10th by itself. And this is the view that Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah and Ibn Hajar al-Haytami and others have strengthened. Okay. The fourth, inshallah ta'ala, is that fasting one day before it and a day after it, based on the riwayah that we mentioned, which is yawman qablahu or yawman ba'dahu, a day before it or a day after it. And Imam Ahmed ibn Khuzayma narrated that. And some of the scholars, of course, they weakened it. Yawman qablahu or yawman ba'dahu. And also another narration, and Imam Muslim narrated, which is la in baqitu ila qabilin la asumanna at-tasi'a. If I live next year, the Prophet said, he said, I will fast on the 9th. And Imam Muslim narrated this, and this is the view of Ba'd al-Hanafiyya and Qawlu al-Shafi'iyya and Ikhtiyar of Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah. And inshallah we'll say, وَلَا إِنْكَارَ فِي هَذَا. There is no inkar in this mas'ala. وَيَكُونُ مِنْ عُمُومِ فَضْلِ صِيَامِ شَهْرٍ الْمُحَرَّمِ. The 10th level, inshallah ta'ala, is fasting on the 9th, the 10th, and the 11th. And this is the best, my brothers and sisters. This is what I highly encourage you all, which is based on the wording of the narration I mentioned, يَوْمًا قَبْلَهُ وَيَوْمًا بَعْدَهُ يَوْمًا قَبْلَهُ وَيَوْمًا بَعْدَهُ A day before it and a day after it. Bayhaqi and Shafi'i narrated this. Okay, and it's been transmitted from Ibn Abbas. وَصَحَحُ بَعْضُ أَهْلِ الْعِلْمِ Some of the scholars authenticated this hadith. Like in the other previous riwayah, Ibn Ahmed narrated, and Ibn Khuzayma, which says, يَوْمًا قَبْلَهُ وَيَوْمًا بَعْدَهُ This, of course, inshallah ta'ala, la tasihhu al-riwayah. That riwayah is not sahih. Okay? Now I want to go into the fourth mas'ala, the fourth point I want to mention, inshallah ta'ala, which is, it is accepted and it is allowed for the person to fast even if there is a qada on him, meaning there is some days of Ramadan that are still outstanding. The person is allowed, inshallah ta'ala, to fast on Ashura. And this is the madhhabu jumhur al-fuqaha, the overwhelming majority of the fuqaha, because they say al-qada is wajibun muwassa. The fasting of Ramadan is a wajib, an obligation, which you can bring back until next Ramadan. Lakin the fasting of Ashura is what? It's a sawmun mudayyak. It's a fasting which is restricted to a particular day. So the scholars here, they say that we shouldn't look at it from the perspective of one being wajib and the other one being sunnah. We should look at it from the perspective of one being muwassa' and one being mudayyak. One being unrestricted until next Ramadan, you can bring it up, which is a long time. And this one being restricted to a particular day. And then if you don't fast it, you have no opportunity after that. So they said here, it's between a muwassa'un wa mudayyak, rather than a wajib versus a sunnah. Okay, so inshallah ta'ala, according to that opinion, inshallah ta'ala, we will say to the person, yasihu an yasum ashura, it is permissible for the person to fast ashura, wa in kana alayhi qada, wa in kana alayhi qada. The fifth mas'ala, inshallah ta'ala, that I want to talk about is, is it permissible? Okay, and is it allowed? At-tashriku bayna niyati sawm al-qada, to combine between the intention of bringing back the fasting of Ramadan with Ashura. So I have some days of Ramadan that are outstanding. What I say is I'm going to fast these 3 days, the 9th, the 10th, and the 11th. But I'll also come with the intention of not only Ashura, but Ramadan as well. So I'm going to combine between the two intentions. Am I allowed to do that? Am I allowed to do that? And this will we say, brothers and sisters, is a mahallu khilafin bayna al-ulama. This issue, there is a dispute, an argumentation, a differences between the scholars in this issue. And there are different opinions. The first view says that it's not allowed. Okay? Even if the person intends to do both of them together. And this is the madhhab al-a'imah al-arba'ah. Because they say, their argument is, لِأَنَّ كُلَّ مِّنْهُمَا مَقْصُودٌ لِذَاتِهِ Both of them, Ashura and Ramadan, are both intended by the Sharia. The Sharia wants each once, يعني, this one the Sharia wants it as a recommended act, and this one the Sharia wants it as an obligatory act. So both of them are intended maqsood لذاته. And so they say that the ibadah which is maqsood لذاته, it has to be separated from the other. They are ibadatani mustaqillatani. They are two ibadah which are independent from one another. So, يعني التشريك بينه وبينه is not allowed. They don't permit that. That's the first view. The second view, they say it is allowed. يعني يصح التشريك في نية. They say it is permissible to bring those two intentions together. And this is the قول of مذاهب الأئمة الأربعة. Okay, the مذاهب الأئمة الأربعة. Okay, and it's the اختيار of the great Imam who recently passed away a few years back. Al-Imam ibn Baz, rahimahullah, Shaykh ibn Uthaymeen. Brothers and sisters, I want to say that, inshallah ta'ala, that which my heart sets with is the first view, that a person should avoid combining between those two intentions and separate them. The sixth benefit, inshallah ta'ala, or the sixth mas'ala that I want to shed light on, inshallah ta'ala, is التداخل بين السنن في الصيام المقيدة والمعين. So, is a person allowed to combine and to bring together the intention between sunnahs a unrestricted sunnah with a restricted sunnah. So for example, am I allowed to, okay, fast the 3 days of Ashura with the intention of the thalathat ayyam min kulli shahr, like siyamu thalathat ayyam min kulli shahr, the fasting of the 3 days of every month, okay, or yani ayyamul bidh, etc. That is fine, inshallah ta'ala, because it's not maqsoodun bi dhatiha. It's not intended in and within itself. This is the view of Ibn Hajar and other great scholars. Okay? The seventh, inshallah ta'ala, is if a person is a traveler, this is the seventh point. If a person is a traveler, it's recommended for that individual. It is recommended for that individual to fast, inshallah ta'ala, yawm Ashura. The reason is because, لِأَنَّهُ لَا قَضَاءَ, because لِأَنَّهُ لَا يُقْضَى, because you can't bring back the fasting of Ashura. It's a sunnah mudayyaka. It's a sunnah which is restricted to that day. You're not allowed to take it out of that day and bring it back another time. This is the view of, and the ikhtiyar of Ibn Abbas. This is the ikhtiyar of Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And it's also the view of Al-Imam Muhammad ibn Shihab al-Zuhri and Hassan al-Basri rahimahumullah. The eighth mas'ala I want to talk about is some people, they say, I will fast on the 9th and the 10th and the 11th. So by doing that, the chances of me not missing Yawm Ashura is very high in case they've got the sighting wrong. Some people say that. So I will fast on the 9th and I will fast on the 10th and I'll fast on the 11th. Okay. So this gives the chances of Yawm Ashura taking place high for me. And I want to say this is mahallu nadar. This issue is not good for you to say that, because you're calling the people to doubt their fasting of Ashura. That's what you're doing to them. Okay? And this is something Al-Imam An-Nawawi rahimahullah spoke about. Rahimahullah rahmatan wasi'ah. The ninth mas'ala, inshallah ta'ala, I want to bring to your attentions, inshallah ta'ala, is it is permissible. You are allowed to siyamu yawm Ashura. You're allowed to fast the day of Ashura idha wafaqa yawm sabt, if it goes in line or with a Saturday. You're allowed to. Okay, you're allowed to. As long as you fast with it. This is the madhab of the Jumhur al-Fuqaha. Okay, and some of the scholars actually say it is permissible for you to fast on Saturday unrestrictedly. This is the madhab al-Malikiyya. As for the hadith that came which prohibits the fasting on Saturday, Al-Imam Ahmed narrated this and Abu Dawood. And as you all know, brothers and sisters who are watching, فَمُخْتَلَفٌ فِي صِحَّتِهِ, there is a dispute and an argumentation and a differences amongst the scholars on the authentication of this hadith. As you know, Imam Malik rahimahullah, he said that it is kadhib, it's a lie. And what did he mean by that? We'll leave that for another time. Imam al-Nasa'i said the hadith is muddarib. Imam al-Zuhri weakened the hadith. Ibn al-Arabi al-Maliki, the great scholar, he weakened the hadith. Ibn al-Mulaqqin rahimahullah weakened the hadith. Imam al-Tahawi weakened the hadith. Ibn al-Qayyim weakened the hadith. So, and it's also Zahiru Kalam Ibn Hajar, that he weakens the hadith. But there are also other scholars who authenticated it, like Al-Imam Abu Hakim al-Naysaburi authenticated it. Ibn Khuzayma rahimahullah authenticated it. Al-Shaykh al-Allama Muhammad Nasiruddin al-Albani, he authenticated it. And I'm more inclined to the idea that the hadith, inshallah ta'ala, is sahih. But the meaning is where I might disagree with the great noble Imam, Al-Shaykh Muhammad Nasiruddin al-Albani, which is that فَيُحْمَلُ عَلَى مَنْ خَصَّصَ يَوْمِ السَّبْتِ. The hadith is talking about restricting Saturday by itself. Okay, that's what it's talking about. But if a person is fasting with it, and he's not looking for Saturday, okay? He's not looking for it. Ashura fell on it. Arafah fell on that day. Okay? Yani, that's what my heart is content with, and the person fasts other days with it, inshallah ta'ala. The second mas'ala, the tenth mas'ala, that I want to share with you is that the fasting of Yawm Ashura, does it expiate the person's major sins for them? So if I fast on the day of Ashura, will it expiate for you your major sins? Based on the hadith that we mentioned before, the answer to that is no. It does not expiate your major sins for you. What it expiates for you is the minor sins alone. And this is the madhab Jumhur al-Fuqaha, because they say لِأَنَّ الْكَبَائِرَ تَحْتَاجُ تَوْبَةً, because the major sins requires repentance specific, يعني توبة خاصة. It requires specific repentance, okay, for a person's sins to be forgiven. The 11th, inshallah ta'ala, point I want to talk about is every single land and every place, they should follow the sighting of their land. Okay, every country should try to follow the ru'yatul hilal of their balad, fi baladihim, in their land. Okay, try to follow that. And this is the madhhab jumhurul fuqaha. If you can't, if your country hasn't sighted it or can't sight it or can't see it, then you follow the neighboring country and the Muslim country that is closest to you that has sighted it, you follow that. The 12th, inshallah ta'ala, point I want to talk about is the ruling of fasting on a Friday. The ruling of fasting on a Friday. And this has many different situations. If a person fasts Friday, but also fasts a day before it, or a day after it, this is allowed by unanimous agreement of the scholars. Point number two, if it goes in line with, okay, in wafaqa aada, if it goes in line with a norms, whatever that norms means, is like Ashura or Arafah or an expiation, it is permissible for you to fast it by itself by unanimous agreement. So if a person, okay, it goes in line with this day of Ashura by itself, or Arafah, or Kafara, that it's permissible, they say, by itself even to fast. Okay? If a person fasts Friday by themselves, by itself, يعني in Sama, a person fasts يوم الجمعة مفردا تخصيصا له. The person fasts on Friday, singling it out. This is a dispute amongst the ulama. They discussed it. Some of the scholars, they said it is haram for you to single out on Friday by itself. Okay? And if a person does that, singles out a Friday, okay, in fasting, they said this is haram. Another view is it is disliked singling Friday fasting. This is the mashhur min madhhab shafi'iyyah wal malikiyyah. Disliked. It's not haram, but it's disliked. And the third view is it is allowed for you to fast Friday unrestrictedly, which is the qawl of Abi Hanifa wa Muhammad ibn Hassan al-Shaybani wa bihi qala Malik wa ashabuhu wa jama'a. That which seems apparent is that the second view, which is that it's disliked. Because the hadith al-Imam Muslim narrated fi sahihihi, where the Prophet said, وَلَا تَخُصُّوا يَوْمَ الْجُمْعَةِ بِصِيَامٍ مِّن بَيْنِ الْأَيَّامِ إِلَّا أَن يَكُونَ فِي صَوْمِ يَوْمٍ إِلَّا أَن يَكُونَ فِي صَوْمٍ يَصُومُهُ أَحَدُهُمْ. The Prophet said, do not specify Jumu'ah, okay, fasting. Do not single it from all the other days. Unless, إِلَّا أَن يَكُونَ فِي صَوْمٍ يَصُومُهُ أَحَدُهُمْ. Unless it's a fasting, one of you used to fast. The 13th, inshallah ta'ala, mas'ala I want to talk about is the fasting of Ashura, as I said, la yuqda ittifaqan. By unanimous agreement of the scholars, you're not allowed to pay back the fasting of Ashura. لِعَدَّمِ الدَّلِيلِ عَلَى ذَلِكَ. Because there's no evidence to say that you can. And it is considered a sunnatun fata mahalluha. It's a sunnah that has gone out of its time, so you're not allowed to fast. The qa'ida is al-a'dhar mimma ta'ummu biha al-balwa walau kana mashru'a al-wurudi. Al-mas'alatu al-rabi'ah, ashara, the 14th and the final mas'ala I want to talk about is some people, they do يعني festivals and things like that on that day. The scholars, they discuss this issue, the jumhur al-fuqaha, they believe that it's recommended. At-tawassu' يعني على الأهل في يوم عاشوراء, they said it is mustahab. This is the madhab al-jumhur al-fuqaha. Okay, another view says it's not allowed to specify this particular day. If you're a person who generally does this, fine, that's no problem. But to specify because it's يوم عاشوراء, a large scholars they said يعني تخصيص في هذا اليوم is what? It is غَيْرُ مَشْرُوحٍ. It's not allowed for you to do it. And to encourage this and etc., it's wrong. And that, inshallah ta'ala, seems to be the strongest opinion in my heart. As for the hadith that some of the people use, which they say that the Prophet said, أن من توسع على أهلي يوم عاشوراء وسع الله عليه سائر سنته. And Imam al-Bayhaqi, of course, narrated that, and others than him, أكثر المحدثين are of the opinion that the hadith is weak. Okay? From them are Imam Ahmed and Abu Zura and Daraqutni and Al-Uqayli and Ibn al-Jawzi and Ibn Uthaymeen and Ibn al-Qayyim and Ibn Rajab and Al-Dhahabi and Ibn Baz and Al-Uthaymeen. And other than them, من العلمائي, they all graded this hadith to be موضوع, fabricated. Okay? And also there's no evidence to suggest such a thing. And we know that if there is a difference of opinion amongst the scholars in a matter, Allah says, فَإِن تَنَازَعْتُمْ فِي شَيْءٍ فَرُدُّوهُ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَالرَّسُولِ إِن كُنتُمْ تُؤْمِنُونَ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ. Inshallah ta'ala, that is all I wanted to share with you all regarding the fasting of tomorrow and some rulings related to it. Inshallah ta'ala, my brothers and sisters, wherever you are, try to fast and try to bring back the fasting of this great sunnah of our Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He makes it a means nearness to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that Allah expiates for us our sins. إِنَّهُ وَلِيُّ ذَلِكَ وَالْقَادِرُ عَلَيْهِ سُبْحَانَكَ اللَّهُمَّ بِحَمْدِ أَشْهَدُ وَلَّا إِلَهِ إِلَّا اللَّهِ أَسْتَغْفِرُكَ وَأَتُوبُ إِلَيْهِ.